Just in time for the holidays, Airfare Wars at 10.
Most unusual holiday movie ever.
Thank you for sharing this holiday occasion with us.
Is this gonna be a party?
I want you to meet my lover.
Happy Thanksgiving!
Is this really happening?
It ain't over till a fat lady sings.
I'm Tom the Turkey Man.
Mary Tyler Moore.
Please don't let me disturb you. I've seen it all. Really?
Tony Curtis.
Michael is going to join us. He's my youngest. I guess the television set is broken.
Thanksgiving Day is more than just a holiday. Now it's a movie. Next.
Just fine, Miss Schloss. Don't you worry, everything's under control.
Somehow I doubt that.
Max, can you pick up Barbara at the airport? I got a million things to do.
No, I can't. I'm taking the colonel to the plant and then after that to the ball game. Why don't you get Michael to do it?
He's asleep.
Well, wake him up. He's in that bed all the time. Oh, by the way, you know, the Crandalls don't like turkey. So why don't you make them one of your roast beefs, huh?
On Thanksgiving? Come on.
So?
The reason we have turkey on Thanksgiving is because the Indians gave the pilgrims turkey, not roast beef. See?
Avril Crandall buys more slouch gloves than any of my clients combined. That's the reason we're going to give them roast beef. Besides, who knows for sure that the pilgrims ate turkey? Were you there? I know I wasn't. Maybe the Indians gave him corned beef. Who the hell knows what the Indians gave him? I mean, I don't know for sure, do you? You really don't. I'm sure they gave him corned beef. Cabbage. The Indians gave the pilgrims turkey, not roast beef.
We don't know that for sure, Richard. It could have been corned beef. Anyway, you know about Mr. Schloss and his customers?
Yeah, the customer's always right. Even if he's stupid.
That's right, Richard. That's the deal.
Hi, Mom.
Happy Thanksgiving.
You got mud all over your shoes.
Oh, sorry.
Grandma, 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 Grandma,
oh, sweethearts, Grandma is so happy to see you. I thought you said this was their Thanksgiving to spend with their mother.
Mom, this is Ginger. She's gonna have dinner with us, too.
Nice to meet you, Mrs.
Schloss, dear. It's Schloss.
I told her I had the greatest looking, sexiest mama in all of Mocha.
Randy,
you're late.
Max, your
yes.
grandchildren.
Oh. You've grown.
Max.
Oh, I'm kidding. Hi. You want some money?
Yeah.
I'll give you the money.
Thanks,
here,
thanks, Max.
Come on, we're late.
Thanks a lot, Mom.
For what?
For keeping an eye on the kids while I'm at the game.
No, no, Randy, I can't. I have to go to the airport and pick up your sister.
Mom, Ginger will stay and help you.
Just tell me what to do, Mrs. Squash. I have brothers and sisters up the kazoo.
Isn't she great, Mom?
That's why I love her.
Randy, stop it.
Randy, don't go.
Hey, Mom, take the kids with. They love the airport, really. Tell them stories about me when I was a kid. Build me up, you know. God knows what their mother tells them about me. I need all the help I can get.
Randy, come back here. Stand for this kind of behavior.
Stop it,
you
Mom.
You are spoiled.
Get a hold of yourself.
You're not a child anymore.
I'm sorry.
Yes, well, you just have to learn to take some responsibility.
I will. I promise.
You promised before.
I'll be a good boy, Mom. Trust me. I swear I'm going to change. I'm going to do everything right from now on.
I should have done this a long time ago.
Mom! Thanks, Mom. You're the greatest. Don't ever change.
What was Randy like as a child?
Nice. As a baby.
Which manager for Smith's mentholated bread and girls? He's a bachelor.
Ryan, I'd like you to meet Alice. She's a bachelorette.
Then I guess you won't be going to the airport then.
Listen, Ryan, will you be able to take the title away from her?
Oh, gosh, yeah.
I'm going to pick up your Aunt Barbara now, and I'll be back in a little while.
We want to go with you, Grandma.
No, Debbie, you and Johnny are going to stay here with your daddy's friend.
I'm sorry, I forgot your name.
That's all right. I'm terrible with names, too.
What's your name, dear?
Ginger Drabowski.
We want to be with you, Grandma. We don't want to be with her.
All right, come on, I'll take you. Let's go. Here we go.
Wait. Johnny needs the car seat, Grandma.
It's not safe. I need a car seat.
You're right. All right. We'll take your daddy's car. How can he live like this?
Grandma Paula?
Yes, sweetheart.
How come there's no pictures of your mom at the house?
Daddy said something terrible happened, but he doesn't know what.
Your daddy said that, did he?
Uh-huh.
Kill him.
What happened?
Nothing. Sweetheart, it's just an accident that her picture isn't up. I will put one out just as soon as we get home. Let me disturb you. I won't look, I promise. I have two boys that I've raised. I've seen it all. Really?
Mom!
Oh, Barbara! Honey, I'm sorry we're late.
What were you doing in the men's room?
Oh, blazing new trails with Johnny.
Johnny! Debbie! You're getting so...
Come on, let's go.
I love your coat.
Yeah, thanks. I got it for our trip to New York next week. I can't wait. It's going to be so much fun to have you with us.
Mom, I feel a little weird going along.
Why?
It's your anniversary. Wouldn't the two of you rather be alone?
What for?
It would be more romantic for you guys. You don't want me getting in the way.
Oh, no, you silly. Your father hasn't gotten it on in years.
Mom, I don't need to know that. Really?
Okay, Candyman. Here we go. Luck is a lady.
She don't want to play, Ginger?
I don't know how to do it.
Mother.
Detroit! Come on in, folks. Welcome to my home.
Oh, you look at those books, darling.
Paula, the Crandalls are here. Hey, kids.
Dad, you've been gone a long time.
Yeah, but look what I got. Yeah, the Lions only lost by 6 today.
Thanks, Dad.
All right.
You weren't betting on the game, were you?
Oh, of course not.
I catch you betting on the game again. You're in the toilet.
What were the points? 6.5. Oh, funny kid you got here. I wish I had a son in the business.
You can have him. I'm only kidding. He's a great kid. I couldn't do without him. One day he's going to be the president of the company. Go get us some drinks.
Sure, Dad. Scotch on the rocks, please.
Oh, your house is beautiful. It's just lovely.
Thank you. I'm glad you like it. I'm so pleased that you're able to join us for the holidays.
How lovely of you to have included us.
Oh, please. Paula.
Hi, Dad.
Barbara. Come on, come here. Oh, this is my daughter, Barbara. That's Melanie and April Crandall.
Great pleasure, Barbara.
Thank you.
Barbara's with us for the holidays. Excuse me. Paula!
Oh, happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, happy Thanksgiving to you.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Barb doesn't celebrate Thanksgiving.
You don't?
I do.
She thinks it's anti-Indian and racist.
You do?
I don't.
Barbara says she's a writer.
Randy, shut up.
But no one's ever seen anything she's ever written before.
And Randy's an idiot, and we see that all the time.
Oh, you got a spot right there, see?
Excuse me.
Oh, I'm out. Kids, will you...
You asked for it, work though.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, this is another. Michael is going to join us. He's my youngest. I guess the television set is broken. Come on down.
It's a bit pale.
Here I come. You can't get away from me.
Whoa!
Ow!
Kitchen!
Stop it, Mom! What? Stop it, you two!
What?
No!
Oh, small one.
Randy!
Get a little tweez
for my big brother.
I say, will you cut it out? Cut the crap. Take care of the crap.
Excuse me for a moment.
Gee.
Hi.
Paula, what are you doing?
Getting things ready. Oh, did you see Barbara?
Yes, I did. I saw Barbara. Listen, come on up, meet the Crandall.
No, I can't right now.
Want to show you something we're pretty proud of.
Oh, darling, the Schloss family treasures.
That's the first Schloss glove ever made right there.
Did you get the roast beef?
Oh, Richard. Max, I'm sorry I forgot the roast beef.
You forgot the roast beef?
Yeah, I had so much on my mind, it just sort of... slipped out.
How could you be so rude as to forget the roast beef?
It wasn't rude, Max. It was an accident. I simply forgot.
I'm telling you, it was rude.
No, Max, I'll tell you what rude is. How about inviting yourself to somebody else's family holiday dinner? That's rude.
Well, the Crandalls don't like turkey. I told you
that. The hell with the Crandalls! So nice of you to come. Welcome. Nice to meet you.
We'll be right down. What is your problem?
Can't we have one holiday where it's just family without any customers?
Who the hell do you think pays for this lifestyle of yours? The car, this house, those damn fur coats of yours?
Max, this may come as a big surprise to you, but I don't really like the idea of killing animals to make fur coats.
Oh, you don't, huh?
Haven't you noticed I never even wear them?
Not really.
Well, if you'd pay attention to me, maybe you would.
We must talk.
We haven't talked in years, Max.
Paula, we have guests. Let's go down for dinner. The children are waiting. We'll talk later. Paula, I love you.
And how come you never touch me?
Oh, Paula, I'm touching you now.
Max, when's the last time we made love?
Paula.
I don't care about the sex. It's just that there's no intimacy. Anyway, I mean, I care about the sex. But you don't... talk to me, don't touch me. I feel like I'm invisible. I'm not getting anything from you, Max.
I'm stunned by what you're telling me. I mean, why haven't you told me this before? I'm not a mind reader. Paula, I'll change.
Oh, Max, I don't think you can.
Oh, change. I can change. Give me a try.
I do hope we didn't embarrass anybody by airing our dirty linen in public.
Nonsense.
We understand. Max did ask me to get that roast beef, and I forgot, and for that I truly apologize.
Turkey'll be fine.
In fact, on behalf of Max, myself, the entire Schloss family, I would like to thank you for sharing this happy holiday occasion with us. Isn't that right, Max?
Mr. Schloss is dead.
Across the country, critics are cheering Dances with Wolves. Two very enthusiastic thumbs up. It's magnificent and visionary, say Siskel and Ebert. One of the great American movies of all time. Absolute magic. Movie making at its very best. And Joel Siegel raves, one of the best films of the year. Don't miss it. Kevin Costner, Dances with Wolves. Rated PG-13. Now playing in select cities. Opens November 21st at theaters everywhere.
Does your sinus medicine put you to sleep? You need Sudafed Sinus with a non-aspirin pain reliever for sinus headaches, plus a decongestant for pressure that starts to work in as quick as 22 minutes without drowsiness. Sudafed Sinus. Fast relief, not fast asleep.
A new high-output 4-liter engine. Anti-lock brakes. And exclusive shift on the fly, full-time four-wheel drive. Make Jeep Cherokee the ultimate vehicle for the hustle and the bustle of everyday life.
Save up to $2,500 on 1990 Cherokees or get 50th anniversary discounts on select 91s.
Have to get on your knees to keep your toilet clean. Just use my 2000 flushes. It has chlorine. Bleaches away stains automatically for up to 4 months. 2000 flushes cleans your toilet with every flush.
Tuesday, glamour and greed.
You have crossed over the line, Harry.
Lead to murder. Who done it? Ben has another idea.
Proof is right here.
On Matlock. Then, Gillespie attempts to save a friend and puts Tibbs' life on the line. A story close to the heart on In the Heat of the Night. Then, a shocking murder rocks a city.
Keep your mouth shut or you're dead.
And threatens to tear apart the force. A fight for law and order on NBC Tuesday.
Three generations bonded by a special love.
Is my grandfather gonna die?
A touching family saga. A warm feel-good story. Superb. Remarkable. It's a bold adventure. It's one pure gem. Michael Landon returns with Art Carney in a family classic nominated for 2 Emmy Awards on NBC Sunday at 7, 6 Central.
Friday, Million Dollar Man versus World Champ Ultimate Warrior. Wrestling so big it has to be in primetime. The main event at 10, 9 Central on NBC Friday.
All these years, man, oh man, oh man.
Why don't you go upstairs and lie down?
No. No, I want to stay here with the family.
Richard, is there anything else to eat?
Is that all you can think about?
You have to eat. Daddy would want us to eat.
It's a shame it had to happen in the turkey. At least Randy wouldn't have to go hungry.
Sweetheart, I think we should leave.
Follow.
Oh, Father Joe, thank you for coming.
As soon as I found out, I'm so sorry. Max was a great man.
The greatest.
Now, I'll take care of all the arrangements.
When will we bury him?
Sunday.
I'm going to give the eulogy.
Well, if you feel up to it.
I don't know if that's such a good idea.
Why? What's the matter?
Well, I just think it would be better if Father Joe gave the eulogy.
I knew Daddy better than anybody. He loved me the best.
He did not. You just thought he did.
Well, he sure didn't like you, not having a job, pretending to be a writer.
No, he wished I was like you, a divorced, gambling, womanizing slob who followed him around the office like a dog.
Yeah, what about you?
Stop it! Just stop the fighting! Let him rest in peace! We're a family! We've got to stick together!
With a tragic story from Sterling Heights, police say...
I can't believe he's gone.
Me too. We'll make it. We just gotta be strong, pick up the pieces, and carry on.
Now you sound like Daddy.
I don't think Daddy and I ever agreed on anything.
He loved you very much.
We had an understanding, Dad and me.
I know you did.
He didn't really do stuff with me like he did with Randy. And he didn't yell and fight with me like he did with Barbara. He didn't buy me stuff like he did with you, Mom. Dad and I just kind of ignored each other. But we knew all along that we loved each other, even though we never really did or said anything to show it.
I know you did. And he knew it, too. Can I tell you something awful? I keep thinking this whole thing might not have happened if I'd got the roast beef.
Don't be ridiculous. It wasn't your fault.
Oh, I know. I just can't help but thinking it was the one thing.
Does it bother you that you and Daddy just had a fight?
No. In fact, I'm glad. We worked some things out. He was going to try harder to make our marriage work.
He was.
And he was really working at it, too. Even if it was only for 15 minutes.
Couldn't you have worn a clean tie?
I just wish that it wasn't so sudden. I wish we would have had some time.
No, I wish that I had told him that I loved him.
He knows you loved him, Richard.
I wish I could have told him that I'm gay.
You're what?
I was going to tell him this weekend.
Well, if the roast beef didn't kill him, this would have.
You're out of the family.
It's not up to you to decide who's in the family or not.
Stop it! Going to your father's funeral.
Randy, this is my new boyfriend, Derek Fromm.
I'm really sorry about your dad.
Yeah, thanks.
I'm really sorry about Max. He was a great father-in-law.
The best.
Hey, I've really been looking forward to meeting you. I'm really sorry it had to be under these circumstances.
Yeah.
Max Schloss's death is a test. A test for all of us. It's a test to his loving wife, Paula. And to his loving children, Michael, Barbara, and Randy. It's a test to everyone who knew him. Max Schloss was a loving, caring husband. He was a fine, sensitive, involved father. And he was an extremely successful businessman. He built up the Schloss Industrial Glove Company from a small storefront shop into a multi-million dollar corporation. And he never said no to a worthy charitable cause. And now, at this time, I'd like to ask Max's eldest son, Randy Schloss, to come forward and say a few words about his beloved father.
This should be good.
We're all here for one reason. Max Schloss, he was my father. He planted a seed in my mother, Paula. I was the only vaginal delivery my mother had. My brother and sister were both born cesarean.
I told you he shouldn't give the eulogy.
I'm sad. My dad's dead, but I'm not crying. Let me tell you why. Let me tell you a story about my dad. When I was a kid, my dog, Wayne, got hit by a car and died. I was crying my eyes out. My dad came up to me and he started screaming as only he could. Cut the crap. Crying isn't gonna bring Wayne back.
Is this really happening?
I told him I was sad and he said so was he. Now I have to go out and buy another dog. Stop it, he said, he's better off dead. Stinks to be a dog. Wayne will probably come back as something better in his next life. I'm sure a lot of you people didn't realize that Max Schloss believed in reincarnation. Well, he did. And so do I. That's why I'm not crying. That's why you shouldn't cry either. His dad will probably come back as something better in his next life. I just hope he doesn't come back as a dog.
What kind of eulogy was that? What is wrong with you?
I thought it was pretty good.
It was totally inappropriate.
Everybody grieves in their own way, Mom.
Yeah, but why do you have to grieve like an idiot?
I'm not an idiot. You are.
Shut up. Stop it!
I never knew Mr. Schloss had so many friends.
Did you see how terrible Ruth Meyer looked?
You should talk. Will you do something with your hair?
What's wrong with my hair?
It's a mess, just like your eulogy. Now, I want you to stretch. I want you to try to behave like a normal human being at your father's wake.
Tony, did you taste this pie?
Tell you, Dad never cut corners.
No, he didn't.
When it came to the gloves, you always used the best materials available, no matter what the cost.
Right, he did.
Try some of the ham.
Which is why Schloss is the best industrial glove on the market today.
Yeah, it is.
Excuse me. Check out the ex-wife.
You asked for a war,
did not?
Yes, he did.
You know, after my hysterectomy, Milt took me on a cruise.
The food was fantastic.
Milt learned how to play bridge.
I highly recommend it.
Mom, I want you to meet my lover.
Oh, I don't know.
Please.
It's all right.
Yeah. It's important to me.
It's okay. It's just Barbara. She's going through her radical feminist stage. Yeah, I mean, think of it this way. At least she won't get pregnant.
How can you go out with such a geek?
He happens to be kind, considerate, responsible. Everything you're not.
I have some money that belongs to your father.
Did my dad loan you some money?
No, I was his bookie.
Bookie? Dad didn't gamble?
Your dad was a heavy player. Now look, Rusty and your mom don't know about this. Let's just keep it between us, huh?
Yeah. These are all hundreds.
Your dad went out a winner.
Oh. Mom, this is Tony.
I'm terribly sorry, Mrs. Schloss.
Well, it's nice finally to...
Hey, Barb, how'd you like to go on a cruise with your mom and us, huh?
I would think you could find something better to do with your father's money than travel around the world on a boat, eating five meals a day and only leaving the ship to buy bad art and tacky souvenirs. Right?
I don't know. Let me think about it.
Yeah. I think I'll go check out Rusty.
So, how about those lions?
Excuse me, gals. Listen, Mom, we'll run out of food. You better call the deli and get some more.
Who died and left you, boss? You want food, order it yourself. Right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
How much he's worth?
His tie is as much as my rent.
Ned Monk!
Look at the way that suit hangs.
Ned Monk! I don't believe Ned Monk came to Daddy's funeral! Ned Monk, it is truly an honor to have you at my father's funeral.
My pleasure.
I didn't even know you and my dad were friends.
We weren't. I'm an old friend of your mother's.
Can I get you something to drink? Bloody Mary, Harvey Wallbanger?
Whatever.
All right, I'll surprise you.
I didn't expect to see you here, Ned.
My deepest sympathies, Paula.
What's the matter with your face?
I had a boil. My plastic surgeon lanced it. Now, ordinarily, I would never be seen in public with something like this, but I wanted to pay my condolences. Now, if there's anything I can do for you, and I mean anything, you just let me know.
Nothing.
I love your outfit. Nobody can pull off black like you. Anything.
What a great guy. Showing up here with that boil and everything? Shows a lot of class.
Well, on this Sunday after Thanksgiving, there was plenty of NFL action, but not a lot for many teams to be thankful about. In Green Bay, the Packers beat the Bears 17-16. The Bears scored a touchdown with 12 seconds left in regulation, but then Kevin Butler missed the conversion, and the Bears lose the game to Green Bay 17-16. You thought you had a bad day? Imagine missing that extra point in a critical game like that one. Imagine a plane ride home. Like getting a root canal for 2 hours without any notice.
How are you doing?
Well, that's a three-team parlay on a missed extra point.
That's not really what I had in mind.
I feel so bad. I can't believe Daddy's gone. I got a pain in my stomach. It just won't go away.
Maybe if you stop eating the pistachios. I have something for you.
His watch.
He'd want you to have it. You're the eldest boy.
Well, I'm going to take over the business. I'm going to make him so proud of me. I'm really going to make it grow. I'm going to be incredible.
Got a cold? Gotta feel better? You gotta get relief with Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine.
It works.
It's fast.
It works fast.
When you gotta get relief fast, you gotta get Alka-Seltzer Plus. And now, for sinus and allergy relief, try new Alka-Seltzer Plus sinus allergy medicine.
Come Sunday, I love chasing quarterbacks. But today, this is more my style, right down to Hanes socks. With socks that look this good, who wants to be running around in cleats? Partner, you either need bigger feet or more Hanes socks to fill those shoes.
The Remington Microscreen shaves as close as a blade, or your money back. Hold it. The Remington Microscreen is more than closeness. Listen. That powerful motor makes Remington a quick shave, and its two thin, flexible screens adjust for true comfort. The Remington Microscreen, quick, comfortable, shaves as close as a blade, or your money back. Attaboy. That's Remington. And the perfect gift for women is the Lady Remington Rechargeable, also with a money-back guarantee.
Bengay welcomes back all the people who tried one of those other pain relievers, but found that for them, nothing works better than Bengay. It warms away pain with two pain relievers, not just one. Welcome back to Bengay, America's best-selling pain relief rub.
Our dentist gave us a reason to switch toothpaste.
Baking soda.
2 out of 3 dentists recommend baking soda for healthier teeth and gums.
And only one major toothpaste has it. Arm & Hammer Dental Care, the baking soda toothpaste from the baking soda experts.
NBC Monday Night at the Movies will return following these messages.
Mammography, one of our best tools for finding breast tumors, but is it effective when deciding whether a tumor is cancerous?
You want people to tell you it's nothing.
Joan Esposito and a special Unit 5 investigation.
Mammography must be used at the right time and in the right way. Otherwise, your life could be at risk.
Mammography, what you should know, tonight on Channel 5 News at 10.
Now, at the Magic Kingdom, Mickey's Starland. At Epcot Center, it's Captain EO in 3D. The exciting Body Wars ride. The Fury of the Maelstrom. And now, the Disney MGM Studios theme park with Star Tours. The Indiana Jones Stunt Spectacular. And the Muppets. For information or reservations, call 1-407-W-DISNEY.
When creating the new G20 midsize luxury sedan from Infiniti, these were just a few of the amenities we kept in mind. Seating surfaces that are fitted with leather. A cabin that heightens the level of comfort and stretches the limits of space. Of course, with 16 valves and 140 horsepower, that mind also has an alter ego.
The meeting that could produce a consensus black candidate for mayor. 10.
Thanksgiving Day continues, starring Mary Tyler Moore and Tony Curtis.
Your dad's favorite shoes. He had such bad taste.
I know.
We'll save these for Randy.
Mom, do you really trust Randy to handle Daddy's business?
I wouldn't trust Randy to handle my luggage.
Then it's simple. Sell the business. Live off the interest.
No, I can't do that to him. Randy's whole ego is wrapped up in this.
Why not? Think of all the terrible things he's ever done to you. To all of us.
Yeah, I have. I raised him the best I could, you know. It didn't work. God knows I did the best I could do. I don't know, maybe it's genetic. Yeah, some kind of chemical imbalance. Anyway, I can't take this away from him. I have to let him at least try to run the business. If I don't help him to grow and love him, who else will? I am his mother.
Why else would you make such a stupid decision?
What's going on?
Pickup, Salvation Army.
Hey, what's going on here?
Mrs. Schloss has made quite a donation.
Well, these suits happen to belong to my father.
Well, they belong to the Salvation Army now.
Hey, Barbara, what is going on here?
We're getting rid of Dad's stuff.
It's only been a week.
Yeah, well, Mom doesn't want the memories around.
Where is Mom?
Hey, this was great on Tony.
You're not giving anything of Daddy's to your little friend.
Had it, Randy. That's it. Oh.
Knock it off. Stop
it. Take it back. Take it back.
No way.
Oh, no. Here comes the drool.
Don't.
I can't control that.
Never stop.
Oh. Oh, no. Here it comes again.
Nice to see things are getting back to normal.
This is normal?
Read the obituaries. Find a widower. That's how Selma got Jack. She was the first one over with a ham after Molly died.
You've got to get another man fast. Unless you want to be pawed by every bald man in Detroit.
Don't rush into another relationship.
Take tap dance some lessons.
Oh, come on, keep it started. One more time, keep going. Keep those feet up. Good. And again, keep going. And grapevine, go. And reverse it, good.
Don't you think it's about time your life meant something to someone? Recycle.
Buy some clothes. Change your hair.
Help the poor. Do something.
Good. One more time. Get us going.
and take me with you.
What hit you, Kentry?
Don't do anything until you get a coat.
If you don't want a date, exercise.
Oh, excuse me.
Sorry.
Hello. Yeah. Yes, great legs.
Yeah.
Attention shoppers, we have a manager special in the produce section today.
They do.
Isn't it great?
Yes.
We're going to have so much fun.
Aren't we, though? Where is your father?
Here comes the shark.
Oh, what's going on?
We're playing shark in the minnow. Hey, Mom, this is Julie.
Hi. I don't believe this.
Oh, it's nice to meet you, Mrs. Schloss. Randy's told me so much about you.
Isn't she great, Mom?
I think I'm gonna marry her.
What have I done to deserve this? Please, just tell me, what have I done?
Mom, calm down, relax. What's the big deal?
Get out of here! Get out of this house!
Can't get out of the house. Mary Beth's going off to Australia with Derek. I can't take care of your grandchildren in my house.
All right. All right, you want to live in this house with your children, then you're going to start listening to me.
What does that mean?
That means that you're going to clean up your act. You're going to wash your car, you're going to clean your room, and you're going to take care of your children. You're going to feed them, bathe them, put them to bed at night, get them up and dressed and off to school in the morning.
I can't get them to school in the morning.
Either you
take
care of your kids or you get out of this house. And get a haircut.
Your mom seems nice. I'm sure we'll become good friends. Morning.
morning, sweetheart.
Morning.
Michael, don't you think it's time you came out of your room?
What for?
There's a whole world out here.
I don't really feel like it.
Well, here, I'll tell you what. Why don't you take the sandwich into the dining room and I'll eat with you?
I don't want to miss the Twilight Zone marathon.
I was just thinking we could spend some time together.
Hello. I'm here to pick up the Randy Schloss children for school.
Johnny, Debbie, your ride's here.
Face it, Mom. You can't beat him.
I can't believe I let him move in. He's going to drive me nuts!
Family?
Hi! Dad?
Yeah!
Your brother looks mighty spiffy.
It's the new and improved Randy.
Well, when you take on a major responsibility, run a major company, you like to look major.
So what are you doing that's so major?
Oh, nothing, Richard. Just thinking of putting in $3 million worth of new equipment.
That's a lot of money.
I know. I'm not afraid of this. You know, Richard, like Dad always said, you gotta risk money to make money.
Here we go.
Hey, where's Randy?
How should I know?
Honey, do we have to be here?
Oh, give it a chance. I've been coming to these games since I was a kid. They're a lot of fun.
Let's go.
He's here! Mom, this is Sally Jo Tuthill.
I think I'm gonna marry her.
Hi, Sally Jo.
It's so very nice to meet you. Randy has told me all about you.
Really? What did he say?
Sally Jo's a dental hygienist. We met last week when she cleaned my teeth. Gotta go.
You know, Randy has very nice teeth, Mrs. Schloss, but he has never learned to brush or floss correctly.
Well, I did the best I could. Maybe you can work with him. Nice suspenders.
Oh, thank you.
For 3 years now, but let me ask you this. Is it all right to eat the little food particles once you get them out from between your teeth?
Good question.
Three bases loaded. Two outs, bottom of the ninth inning. This is what the Schlosses live for.
Come on, Randy! No!
Take your base.
He got hit on purpose, huh?
We'll get it over.
He stepped into it with his head.
What kind of a jerk would get hit in the head off purpose?
A jerk like you?
Yeah?
Yeah.
A jerk like me just won the game, man.
Oh, yeah? Well, yeah. Come back here. I hit you in your head.
Oh, man. So fast.
Come on, man.
Save the earth!
Mom, you can't go out on a date.
Excuse me?
The year isn't up until Thanksgiving.
Oh, give me a break.
Listen, I don't make the rules. That's just the way it is. You don't wear white before Memorial Day. You don't drink red wine with fish. And you don't start dating again until a year after
it's
your husband
died.
It's
been 9 months. And Saul Minion asked me out.
Saul Minion? He's a drunk.
He was your father's cardiologist.
Well, he did a really good job, didn't he? He's probably been lusting after you for years. That guy's a real lech. He goes after anything in a skirt.
You should talk.
Come on, Mom. He's been divorced 3 times. I mean, if you're going to go on a date, you ought to go out with Ned Monk. He's interested, you know.
You forget about Ned Monk. Just...
Ever since Dad's been gone, this whole family's been screwed up.
I think we're doing just fine.
Oh, sure. Barbara's a lesbian. Michael doesn't come out of his room, and you're running around with Saul Minion.
You don't like who I see. You don't like what I do. You don't like the way I raise my family. It is as though I were still living with Max.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Nothing. Except that Max was my husband. You're my son. See?
Feeling I'm happier. That meter running, baby. If I get lucky tonight, you get lucky. Could be the biggest fare you ever had.
You're not getting lucky, Saul. You're going home.
How about a little good night kissy, boy?
Get real. You are drunk.
No, I'm not.
You're disgusting.
It's bad anchovy.
The whole evening was a bad anchovy. And do you want to know the worst part? Randy was right. That has never happened before.
Paula, I want you. You drive me crazy. For 30 years, I've wanted you. Max used to bring you to the club. I'd see you in those short dresses with those gorgeous, luscious, long legs. Yeah. I want you, Paula. Yeah, I'm a sensitive guy.
I'm sorry, but after careful review, our bank has decided we can't grant you your request for a loan.
You're sorry? What about me? You're my attorney. Do something.
Well, I thought if I...
Come on, I pay a huge retainer. What are we supposed to do?
I don't know.
How are we supposed to get the money for the new machines?
I don't know.
You're the reason America can't compete in the foreign market.
Randy...
You're why we're getting pushed all over by Koreans and the Japanese and Hong Kong. You probably drive a Mazda.
Actually, I drive a Chrysler.
Yeah? I'm gonna pull our money out of here immediately.
Randy, settle down.
No, I want every stinking penny right now.
You can't pull it out.
Well, yeah? Why not? Give me one damn reason.
You owe us more than you have in the bank.
Sure is great. Get out here. Get about business for a while. I can't believe you accepted my invitation.
My pleasure, young man. Did your mother say anything about me after the funeral?
No, no. No, that business. It's crazy, isn't it? I mean, it's not one thing, it's another.
Very perceptive observation, young man. Did she start dating anyone seriously?
Nah, it's like some drunk who barfed in our bushes. But you know, Ned, money sure is tight these days. Well, not for you, of course. You're Ned Monk, right?
That's right. Has she been acting lonely at all?
Who?
Your mother.
Yeah. You know, you want to go out with my mom, Ned.
You think so?
Yeah, she's got a great body.
Well, she doesn't seem to want to have anything to do with me.
Why not? You've got a great body, too.
I know. But it's because of something that happened a long time ago.
Hey, watch it!
Ah, hell. Times change. So do people, Ned. I could put in a good word for you. Maybe, you scratch my back, I can scratch yours.
Maybe, young man. Maybe.
I think you still like her, Ned. Ned and Paula sitting in a tree. K-I-S-S-I-N-G. First comes love, then comes marriage. Then comes Ned in a baby carriage. Yeah.
Very humorous. What a yo-yo.
So how's Michael?
He's all right. I wish he'd get out of his room, you know, do something.
He will when he's ready. Oh, I would love to fix him up with my periodontist daughter. She is adorable.
Really? Well, yeah. Then do. Fix them up. You know, he watched 12 hours of Lucy the other day.
I got the load.
Yahoo!
Randy. The new machines will be in by fall.
What? I thought you said that the bank turned you down.
They did, but I just played 18 holes with Ned Monk.
You play golf with Ned Monk?
Yeah, Ned's got the bank in his back pocket. It was a small favor. He's being honored as Homeless Man of the Year. We're going to get a table, and that'll be it.
Well, that's great. I hope you didn't tell Ned that I would be coming to this Man of the Year dinner.
Why?
Because I'm not going.
What happened between you and Ned Monk?
Nothing, and I'm not going. Randy, do something with your hair.
Wait a minute. Mom, Ned said something happened a long time ago. What happened?
Nothing.
Come on, tell me what happened.
Randy, will you please stop bugging me? Just stop bugging me.
I'm going to keep bugging you until you tell me what happened.
So, guess who I talked to the other day? Sally.
How is she?
Oh, she's great. You know, she's starting
to... She still dance. Will you? All right. I will tell you. Ned and I were engaged.
You and Ned? You picked Daddy over Ned Monk? I don't believe it. I could have been rich. Although I wouldn't have been born.
Don't excite me.
Why'd you break off the engagement?
That's none of your business.
Oh, nuts. I could have been a monk.
Coffee.
If you go to the Ned Monk banquet, I'll cut my hair.
You what?
I'll cut my hair.
Any way I want?
Any way you want it. Mohawk, buzz, afro.
No, I don't want you to get a buzz. I just want you, for the first time in your life, to look like a normal, decent human being.
I could try.
Afternoon of playing grandparent can take quite a lot out of you. Magnesium, for example, vitamin B6, vitamin C, and valuable potassium. As nature would have it, replacing all of them is as simple as eating one Chiquita banana. In the case of twins, however, you might want to try two. Chiquita, quite possibly the world's perfect food.
Mmm, what's that fragrance you're wearing?
Without saying a word.
The baby in this picture is going to have a very special year. A year of first steps, first words, first birthday. And none of these firsts will ever happen again. Now, if you were this baby's parents, which film would you choose? No other film in the world gives you truer color than Kodacolor Gold film. Aren't your pictures worth gold?
Put the power of an upright in the palm of your hand with the Royal Dirt Devil. It has a revolving brush, and it can handle all kinds of dirt. Pick up the handheld vac that really picks up. Dirt Devil by Royal.
Grandma, what's butter for?
So my cookies will taste special for the family reunion.
Why?
Butter makes them taste better.
Why?
Butter's natural. Here, taste.
Delicious. Because it's butter.
Real butter makes family reunions taste even better.
NBC Monday Night at the Movies will return following these messages.
Thursday, it's a Thanksgiving feast the whole family's gonna love, starting with America's favorite family, the Cosbys.
God bless America.
Then, make room for more fun as the laughs continue on A Different World. And for dessert, how does an all-new cheer sound?
I like it.
Good, then you'll love an all-new grin.
Great idea.
Thanksgiving night on NBC Thursday.
This is Channel 5, your 24-hour news source.
The shuttle Atlantis is stuck in space, at least temporarily. The shuttle was scheduled to land at Edwards Air Force Base today, but because of high winds, the landing has been rescheduled for tomorrow. If necessary, the shuttle could stay up until Thursday. The saber rattling in the Persian Gulf goes on, this time Saddam Hussein sending 250,000 more troops to Kuwait. More news later.
And for traffic every 10 minutes on the ones, tune to WMAQ Radio.
Last year, the Illinois lottery lengthened Michael Jordan's hang time. This year, we leave it in your hands. The 1991 Michael Jordan flip book date book.
And make sure this is not the only book you pick up. Say yes to graduation.
Pardon me, viewers. If you want to see the world's largest fish, go on up to Hayward, Wisconsin. The world's largest prairie chicken, Rotze, Minnesota. And if you want to see the world's largest statue of Hiawatha, you have to go to Ironwood, Michigan. But if you want to see the world's largest 12-pack of beer, just go to your favorite store. The Strohs and Strohs Light 15-can 12-pack with three extra cans. A holiday special.
You are in for the three-year drive of your life. Introducing the brand new 1991 Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme. And introducing the smartest way to drive one. The Gallant Men of Old's three-year smart lease. Just $295.82 a month for a loaded 1991 Cutlass Supreme. And at that price, we know it's right on track.
On the next hard copy, she's an acting student by day, but by night, this decoy call girl leads us on an undercover investigation into Middle America vice. It's not supposed to happen in small-town America, but it is. So we're hitting the streets and going inside the world of the upscale call girl.
My big thing is the family guys that all come up in their station wagon.
Don't be surprised what goes on when the sun goes down in your hometown on hard copy.
Join us tomorrow at 6:30.
Right before Matlock.
Mammography, what you should know, tonight at 10.
Thanksgiving Day continues, starring Mary Tyler Moore and Tony Curtis.
Oh, is this going to be a party? Come on, you got to see this.
Disgusting. They're just using all those poor homeless people.
They seem to be having a good time.
Don't you see they're just pawns? Why do you have to criticize everything?
I don't mind Barbara's being gay. I just wish she was happy.
I thought it was important to attend things as a couple. Maybe I was wrong.
Hey, come on, let's go.
Yes, go on. Oh, I am so sorry.
Oh, well, that's okay.
Excuse me.
No problem, no problem. Sid Bramenthal.
You used to represent the Black Panthers.
Yes, I did. I did. I didn't think anyone remembered.
I did my thesis on sexism among the Black Panthers.
No kidding.
Panthers were a bunch of pigs.
Well, okay. Hey, can I buy you a drink?
Sure.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Detroit's homeless man of the year. Here you are. Yes, sir. Come on up here, man. Let's hear it again.
Detroit has been very good to Ned Monk. And it is Ned Monk's pleasure to be able to give something back. Woo-hoo! My grandparents settled in Detroit. And through hard work, they were able to establish a thriving German-American delicatessen.
Rusty sure looks foxy tonight. Bet you two are gonna do a little howling when you get home, huh? We've got a problem, Randy. Ah, quality is not everything. Timing's important. I'm talking about we have a problem.
A tradition was started.
Oh, yeah.
My grandfather, Adolf Monk, opened his heart.
We're talking about a great deal of money, and if it wasn't for my relationship with your parents, you'd be in big trouble.
To give them his day-old Kaiser rolls. And his pumpernickel heels. So tonight is a very, very special occasion for me, because it gives me great self-gratification to be able to bring to the homeless something that they need today, a taste of Nouvelle Cuisine.
Oh, that's medallions of free-range grouse. It's divine.
I'm only sad to say.
Can I make a bet this weekend? No, you're cut off.
Heinrich and Ilse Monk.
I'll carry you for the time being, but sooner or later you're going to have to come up with a scratch.
But I am very heartened, however, that there is amongst you tonight an old dear friend. Someone who knew me when I was poor. Someone of exquisite taste, consummate grace, fine womanhood, and impeccable... adultness. Ladies and gentlemen, Paula Schloss. Paula.
What?
This means so much to me to have you here tonight, sharing with me and all these people this celebration of me. Thank you.
I hate everything Ned Monk stands for.
Oh, he does a lot of good with his money.
If you believe that, you're even more naive than I thought you were.
You know, Tony, you are a complete drag.
Well, if that's the way you feel, maybe we should just split up.
Well, that's the way I feel.
Whoa. What's going on there?
That's it. Tony and I are through.
I'm sorry.
You are?
Well, I'm not sorry you broke up, but I am sorry if it makes you unhappy.
You are?
Is this what you want, sweetheart?
I don't know. It's been building for a long time.
I think I know what's happened.
I think you spent so much of your life rebelling against your daddy. And now that he's not here, you're just not sure who you are.
Oh, Mom, that's not it. I just wish he wasn't such a jerk.
Well, that too. Randy.
Look at that, look at that.
No one else could have joined.
Come on.
No.
You look wonderful, Paula.
I'm getting old.
We all are. What a great couple.
You've never lost that rare, unspoiled beauty. Have you been? This must have been a difficult year for you.
Doing the best I can. I've had my ups and downs.
Can you find it in your heart to forgive me?
Ned.
I worship the ground you walk on. I've been obsessed with you all these years.
Ned, please.
I've never been able to love another woman.
Stop.
Please, Paula. I need your forgiveness.
Get a grip.
I can't get a grip. I've never been able to get a grip when it comes to you. We didn't complete our long. We have to complete it.
Dad, you're making a scene. Please stop.
I can't stop. I'm out of control.
See?
Oh, God.
Please, Paula. You must forgive me. You must forgive me. Pretty, please.
All right, I forgive you. Now get up.
Thank you. Thank you.
Schloss, Mr. Ned Monk wants to speak with you.
No, tell him I'm not here.
He's called three times.
Hello?
Paula, I just called to tell you how much I appreciated last night.
It was nothing. Forget it.
Oh, no, it meant the world to me, Paula. I've waited so many years to hear you say those words.
Well, I'm glad that we could...
We could what?
Dance.
I'd like to see you.
I don't know, Ned.
Paula, I insist that we have dinner together. Just dinner, nothing more.
I'm sorry, Ned, but I don't want to go out with you.
You said you forgave me.
And I did forgive you. But I will never forget what you did.
Something amiss, Ned?
She won't go out with me. After I made a complete fool of myself. After I groveled at her feet. That's why I said, pretty please.
Patience, patience, Ned. Wait a little while and then call her again.
I can't wait any longer, Crandall. I have to have her now.
Ned, I can find you women that'll make you forget Paula Schloss faster than you can say Paula Schloss.
I don't want any other women. I've had women all over the world. Every woman I ever pursued, I had. I've had virgins in Beirut. I've had Amazons in Brazil. I've had pygmies in New Guinea. I've had the wives of senators. I've had the daughters of presidents. But the only woman I ever really wanted, the only thing I ever really wanted, I couldn't have. Paula Schloss, 30 years ago, she loved me, but she got away. And I spent all those years waiting while she was married to that schlub. Well, now he's finally croaked. I'm not gonna wait any longer. I have to have her now! It's time to lower the boom on the Schloss family.
It's a bit extreme, isn't it, Nettie?
These are extreme times, Avril. Extreme times.
Where's my brandy? It's the way it is, Randy.
You've gotta be kidding.
I wish I were. Most auto companies are going to be using Korean gloves from now on.
But a Schloss glove is the best in the business.
I know that, Randy. But it doesn't seem to matter anymore. All they care about are cutting corners. Last year it was cheaper plastic. This year it's industrial gloves. I'm really sorry, Randy.
Really sorry, Randy.
I know we were your biggest account.
Yeah. My dad dies, and you drop us like a lead balloon.
Oh, borscht! Max would have been the first to understand.
My dad was a great man. He loved America, loved Detroit, loved to work, and he loved to play. And because of his great concern for children and the plight of the urban ghetto, I dedicate this park in the memory of my late father, Max Schloss.
Too bad your dad isn't here to see this. He would have hated it. You know, too bad he isn't here to hate it.
Amazing Max, how sweet the sound, how kind the gift of love. This precious heart,
the devastation
Mike.
Was utter and complete.
Can we talk?
The turning point came about perhaps in March of 1944. American B-17 aircraft levied an assault against the Reich and sent a volley of bombs out over the roof.
Things sure started getting weird since Dad died, huh? Do you know Uncle Milt was Dad's bookie? Mom and Aunt Rusty don't know. So don't say anything, right?
He gave me $25,000 that Dad won. So I start betting, you know, a little bit here, a little bit there. Next thing you know, I owe him $50,000. That's not really the bad thing. I started fooling around with Sandra Birnbaum, you know, our sales manager. I don't know what it was, my ego or something. I asked her, who's better in bed, me or Dad? She says, Dad. So I fired her. So she takes all her accounts to my competitors. Now my number one account tells me he's leaving, and I owe $3 million on glove machines I can't pay for. I know it sounds bad. There's a lot I can do. I gotta meet with different banks all next week, and I'm gonna bust my butt to get some new clients. I know I can do it. I know I can do it. If I just put my mind to it. Hey, if there's one thing a Schloss knows, it ain't over until a fat lady sings. Hey, Mike. Thanks for being there for me, man.
I'm Tom the Turkey Man, delivering turkeys as fast as I can. Gotta go, so I'll just say, cook this turkey on Thanksgiving Day. Happy Thanksgiving from Ned Monk.
Tell Mr. Monk I said thank you. We're having roast beef. But you're very good. Excellent.
It's been a whole year.
Time moves on, Richard. It moves on.
It doesn't seem the same. Thanksgiving without a turkey.
Doesn't seem the same Thanksgiving without Mr. Schloss.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Richard.
Hi, sweetheart. Hi, Sid.
Did you hear about what happened down in Skid Row?
No, what?
Ned Monk. He gave a whole truckload of turkeys to the homeless in your name.
It must have cost him $10,000.
He doesn't give up, does he? I mean, I suppose it's very nice, but he is driving me crazy. His gifts, his phone calls, he won't leave me alone. And we have you to thank for that.
Mom, can I talk to you? Alone?
Oh, well, we'll be in the other room trying to achieve the perfect relationship.
What's wrong?
It's the business.
What about the business?
We're ruined, Mom. I lost everything.
What are you talking about?
We're broke. Belly up. Busted.
What happened?
A series of unforeseeable circumstances. I can't pay the bank back. We're ruined!
Are you serious?
Yes.
You've run the business for 1 year, and you have lost everything?
I overexpanded. I lost my market. Guys go broke all the time, Mom. It's part of business. Ask the attorney.
How could I have been so stupid?
Quit, Mom!
All right, calm. Just calm.
Already pie crusts. Scratch quality and nothing flat. It's easy as pie. Nothing says lovin' like my already pie crust.
What do you give a man who has the spark, the style, the edge? What do you give a man who has the look, the touch, the smile?
Preferred stock.
The extra smooth cologne from the House of Stetson.
The new and now.
Preferred stock. The extra smooth cologne for an extra special man.
It's real life. Real funny. It's America's funniest home videos. And now it's a game you can play at home, featuring hundreds of the show's most amazing and hysterical home videos. Just pop the tape in your VCR, and you'll be voting. Winning. Even writing your own captions.
Eat your soup.
Ali wanna know?
Play America's Funniest Home Videos game, because real life is hilarious.
A Sargento shredded cheese makes any dish easy to prepare and impossible to resist. Sargento of Wisconsin.
Wednesday, she was an innocent little girl snatched away from her family. You can help bring her home for the holidays. All new Unsolved Mysteries on NBC Wednesday.
For the first time in history, Penn and Teller, the bad boys of magic, pull off the biggest, most stupendous magic stunts ever seen on TV. Then they show you how they did it.
Is there no end to the madness?
Victoria Jackson and Jane Curtin join Penn and Teller in an all-new NBC special. Don't try this at home. Friday at 8, 7 central.
Helen, she is my light. When she left, I could no longer see. To inhale her beauty. To choke on her innocence were my greatest joys.
Shave me. Grant me one wish.
Anything.
Get off my foot.
There are many shows on Friday night, but only one. Wings.
Ah, the fun of it.
Did you ever watch three little kids learning to count? One counts on the right hand, the other counts on the left, and the third goes straight for the toe. The thing is, all kids can learn, but they all learn in different ways, so try not to compare your kids to each other or to anyone else's kids. Just try to encourage them. Because the more you know about how your kids learn, the more you'll know how to help them.
See, this is great, serving roast beef instead of turkey on Thanksgiving. I mean, who knows what the Indians gave the pilgrims? It could have been lasagna.
That is so bizarre, Sid. Maybe we should stop meeting on Thanksgiving. It hasn't really brought us good luck.
That's true. A loss would be one thing, Randy, but it takes real talent to blow a multi-million dollar company in one year.
Don't be so hard on him. He didn't do it on purpose.
Thanks, Michael.
I know how you feel.
I can't believe you got to sell everything. That is very unusual.
Even the house, Grandma?
Even the house, Grandma?
Yes, my darlings. Even the house.
Jeez, Dad.
Where will we live?
I guess I'll have to get an apartment. There is enough money left for that, isn't there?
Listen, this will just be for a while. All successful men make and lose millions. I'll figure some way out of this.
Don't do anything.
Gotta try and get it back.
No, I don't. Nothing. Rest. Cars.
Paula, I was so sad to hear about your business misfortune.
Well, thank you, Ned. I never should have allowed Randy to run the business in the first place.
Have dinner with me tomorrow night. It'll cheer you up.
Oh, I don't know.
Come on, Paula. This is serious. Maybe I can help.
All right, I'll have dinner with you.
Paula, you've only made me the happiest man in the world.
Yeah. That. Oh, yeah.
Dinner was delicious.
I had each oyster flown in from a different sea just for you.
Oysters have always been a favorite of mine.
If I remember correctly, you also used to love Mozart.
Oh.
You're a bassoon, sir.
Thank you.
You play the bassoon, Ned?
I just took it up recently. It provides the purest sounds of all the woodwinds. Please.
All right.
Thank you.
Give me that.
You want to know the worst part of all this?
What?
I don't know if Randy really loves me.
Of course he loves you. You're his mother.
I know he's supposed to love me. Maybe he even thinks he loves me, but deep down, I don't know if he really loves me. How could he have done this to me? How could he have done everything that he's ever done to me?
Oh, this is great. Pretty good turnout, huh?
It's horrible.
Oh, it is?
Everything your father ever worked for. Our home, our security, it's all gone. You ruined us.
I know how we're going to get it back.
How?
Fish farms.
Fish farms?
Yeah. Beef is out. There's tremendous need in this country for fresh catfish.
I don't want to hear another word about the need for fresh catfish.
Once the first fish farm hits, you can start a million of them.
I should have sent him to military school.
Would have been kicked out in an hour.
And you end up owning the land, Mom. Michael, Barbara. Listen, Richard, man, you gotta trust me on this. I mean it.
Catfish is some pretty good eating.
Oh, this is great. Come on, kids. Oceline's family had some fish. E-I-E-I-O.
Didn't I tell you? Take a look at this, huh?
Yes, this is so great, isn't it?
Well, that's the end of Michael.
He'll be back.
I doubt that.
There's only one TV.
Ooh, what do we have in here? Wow, this is really nice. Boy, I better call Sid and give him the number.
Who?
Sid.
Hey, since you've been seeing so much of Sid lately, does that mean, you're not gay anymore?
Well, I guess I'm bisexual.
You are?
Yeah. Does it matter?
Nah, not really. You're my sister. I'll always love you, no matter what.
Okay, Debbie, cornflakes for you?
Cornflakes, please.
You got it. Whoops. There you go. Plate place for me.
Can be done, but not by you.
Summer when Dad made me work construction, so I wouldn't turn out like Randy.
Today, there's a diet pill that can help you lose weight without being hungry and without caffeine to make you nervous.
All my life, I've been struggling with my weight. With Dexatrim, I finally lost weight and without being hungry.
Dexatrim can help you lose weight, too. Just one works all day, morning through bedtime, to control your appetite and help you lose weight.
Dexatrim did it for me. I lost weight and feel great.
Today's caffeine-free Dexatrim. Nothing works harder to help you lose weight.
10 years down the road, I'd like to be in business for myself.
I've already got my security force.
That's right, partner. We got us a lifetime contract. Here's my part of the bargain.
Alpo. More meat protein than 10 pounds of steak, fortified with all the vitamins and minerals dogs need to eat well and be well, well into the future.
Now, there's something you gotta understand, Max. Security guard's supposed to be me.
Okay?
Soggy first date, huh?
He's really funny, Linda.
Oh, you smell great.
Emerald.
I got a raise.
You pay.
This is going too well.
You've been dating 6 months.
Seven.
Let's stay in tonight.
Linda, I think he's the one.
Hun, let's get this Remington micro screen shaver for your father. It's got a separate clipper, and it's rechargeable worldwide.
He hasn't left our house in 3 years.
Well, maybe this'll give him the idea.
NBC Monday Night at the Movies will return following these messages.
It's your favorite parade with Scott Bakula, Raven Simone, the guys next door, and more big stars. Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade on NBC Thursday.
Thursday, O.J. Simpson visits live with U.S. servicemen and women serving our country in the Persian Gulf. Then it's the Broncos and the Lions, a special Thanksgiving on NBC.
This news preview is sponsored by Ameritech Pages Plus and Walgreens.
Tonight on Channel 5 News at 10.
Poor image quality can mean missed breast cancers.
Mammography and breast cancer. How reliable are the tests? Tonight, how you can make sure you're getting accurate test results. Also, charges of Satanism surface in the brutal murder of a Valparaiso store clerk. And how a new round of airfare wars could mean big bargains for holiday travelers. Join Ron Majors and Carol Marine tonight on Channel 5 News at 10.
Sports Talk.
Lou, I know you're there. Tonight's my birthday, so how about a cake that isn't a football and a present with lace, not laces?
Lou, where are you going to find that stuff?
At Walgreens, our pharmacy computers are customer-friendly, and whenever a generic equivalent is available, they print it right on the receipt. Walgreens, the customer's best friend.
Just in time for the holidays, Airfare Wars at 10.
Thanksgiving Day continues, starring Mary Tyler Moore and Tony Curtis.
Love the way your fingers smell. Like damp wood. Marry me, Paula. You love me once, you can love me again.
Ned, please.
Your money problems will be over forever. I will sign an ironclad prenuptial agreement. All you have to do is sleep with me on the wedding night. I just want one opportunity to win you back. If you change your mind after that, I'll take my chances.
Poached Chinook salmon.
It's so good to see you back at the club. It was such a shame you had to drop out.
Yes, well, it's nice to
Irving,
be welcome back.
Is it true that Shuki Saban's going public?
Paula, tell me everything about you and Ned Monk.
Do I have to?
I think I took you to lunch because I like you.
Well, he is relentless. He wants me to marry him.
It's hard to imagine you married to Ned Monk. He's so smarmy.
Yeah.
Although I should talk Mildane exactly Julio Iglesias.
Can I tell you something really disgusting?
Yes.
I'm still attracted to him. I always was. Well, we were engaged. And there are feelings that are not easy to control.
I never experienced those kind of feelings. But I picked Milk because he was my only offer. But I slept around a lot.
Watch your step.
Oh.
Be careful now. Take it easy. All right, easy.
Mom! Isn't this incredible? You're out of your minds. Here comes Michael!
Come on, watch this.
They're all crazy.
Richard, get out of the kitchen.
Oh, come on, Randy, let me help.
You, just sit down and relax.
Hey, I don't know if I can do that.
You can do it. You know, we got the whole system computerized. The date, the sale, the amount. You know, Barbara sold orders for almost 2,000 pounds a week.
I am not very good at it. I should have sold a lot more.
Sounds like you're doing great.
Hard to believe Max has been gone a year and a half. Business is destroyed. Lost our home. And we're living on a fish farm.
I like it.
They're like the Brady Bunch.
Wait till you taste my spaghetti.
Moose is asleep. He's dreaming of moose drinks. The goose is asleep. He's dreaming of goose drinks.
That's well and good when a moose dreams of moose juice. Nothing goes wrong when a goose dreams of goose juice.
Anything happening?
They've laid the eggs.
Yeah!
Oh, wow!
Yeah! Woo! All that for Bond yes. City!
Well, you can't just expect it to happen on the exact day that it's supposed to.
Fish have a very specific gestation period.
Yeah, well, good for them. Barbara, where did Randy borrow the money to do all this? He won't tell me.
I promised I wouldn't tell.
I don't believe this. You've always told me all Randy's secrets.
He's never done anything good before.
He's doing something good, isn't he?
Yeah.
I just talked to the head of the fishery. Fish didn't acclimate to their new environment.
Relax. It's only been a week.
If it hasn't happened within a week, it isn't going to happen. We're dead meat. It's over.
Maybe I am just a loser.
I don't think so.
Right.
I've never seen this family so together. Everyone getting along with each other. Your kids are thriving. It's beautiful to see. That's what's important. And that's something your father, God rest his soul, never could do.
Thanks for the support, Mom. It really means a lot. I want you to know that I'm gonna get Richard his life savings back. It's the last thing I ever do.
You took money from Richard?
Yeah, he's like a member of the family.
You took money from Richard?
Yeah, relax.
Randy,
he gave it to me.
You have no conscience.
Calm down, Mom.
Let me hit you.
You're gonna hurt yourself. Mom, you're gonna hurt me.
What have I raised? I know everyone is upset, but I have some good news that I want to share with all of you. I'm getting married.
What?
Ned Monk proposed, and I decided to accept.
Ned Monk? Congratulations! When's the happy day? We'll have the wedding right here at the farm. It'll be wonderful.
Actually, Ned has offered to have it at his house, and he's willing to pay for it.
No way. We're going to do this right. We're going to have the wedding at the Schloss Farm right here, and I'm going to give you away.
Please don't give Grandma away.
He won't, sweetheart.
Is he going to give Grandma away?
No, darling, no. It's a figure of speech.
Rocky Fives, a powerhouse 10.
Yo, Rocky! Yo!
Don't ever stop for a moment.
Go for it!
You say go!
Yo, Rocky!
Yo!
Don't ever stop for a moment.
Stallone gives a remarkable performance in a remarkable movie. Rocky Five, rated PG-13, now playing at theaters everywhere.
It was interesting. A couple of the students every once in a while would say, "Geez, Mr. Trapone, you know, you got these little specks, you know, can't you learn how to shave?" The last 6 weeks I've been shaving with the Norelco, and I'm going to stick with it forever. Most definitely you can get a close and comfortable shave with the Norelco razor.
Now, Norelco's patented lift and cut system has been improved to lift each hair and cut it even closer without the blades touching your skin.
My wife said, "Geez, it's nice not to see your face all marked up."
The new Norelco, a new level of closeness and comfort.
Floor's all shiny clean, Billy.
He should know. It's called break.
Let's play.
Time to entertain Daddy. Wow, never seen such clean shininess.
Billy, look.
How did Bright do this so glossy clean?
Unlike Mop and Glow, Bright is self-cleaning, so it gives your no-wax floor a cleaner shine every time.
Up goes the ladder.
Hey, I have hair.
Bright, for a cleaner shine every time.
Whoa, nice reflection.
He noticed.
Tonight, the sauce is ragu old world style.
Our dentist gave us a reason to switch toothpaste.
Baking soda.
2 out of 3 dentists recommend baking soda for healthier teeth and gums.
And only one major toothpaste has it. Arm & Hammer Dental Care, the baking soda toothpaste from the baking soda experts.
The movies this weekend on NBC.
Showtime.
In the Line of Duty 1 took you inside the FBI's deadliest day. Now comes a brand new In the Line of Duty.
Isn't this a lovely way to spend an evening?
The actual plot against the local police department.
It's a trap.
It's all down the toilet now.
The ambush that tore family and friends apart.
Trying to assess the need for deadly force.
One of my guys is dead. There's your need.
And how they vowed never to let it happen again.
I said him now!
And all new In the Line of Duty, Sunday. And on Monday, they were the perfect family.
To my mother, I love you.
Kept apart by their mother's secret.
I can't stand it anymore.
Please come home.
Inspired by a true story of a shattered family.
Why is she shutting us out?
That wanted to know what it meant to love each other.
They need you.
Talk more with strangers than I've talked with you in my entire life.
L.A. Law's Michelle Green.
What's wrong with me?
And Rue McClanahan in a powerful performance.
Don't we have to find some place to start?
the world premiere of To My Daughter Monday. The movies this weekend on NBC.
Guess this means we'll be going into business, right, Dad?
Right, son.
Hey, Mr. Kilman, how are you?
Good hat. I just stopped by to say so long.
What are you... What's wrong?
Schlossers don't need me hanging around now.
Oh, no, no. I will make sure that Ned Monk takes care of you, just like the rest of us.
Look, I don't want that man's money. You're making a big mistake.
Really? What's so terrible about a mother wanting to protect her children?
Look, I know what happened between you and Ned Monk.
You do?
You've worked for a family for 30 years. You know everything. I mean, everything.
Mom? Ned? Mom?
Paula, this is not what it seems.
Who knows what really happened? Maybe my mother seduced Ned Monk, like in The Graduate.
That was a movie. And in The Graduate, Mrs. Robinson seduced Dustin Hoffman before he even met her daughter. I mean, this was real. You were engaged to Ned Monk.
Yeah, but if I can forgive him and agree to marry him, I think you should be able to do that, too. Forgive him, not marry him. Think about it.
Mom? Are you happy?
Oh, yes, sweetheart, I am.
Really? You're not just doing this for us?
Yeah.
Of course she isn't. Great dress, Mom.
You don't think it's a little much?
No. If I didn't know better, I'd think you were a virgin.
Because it was Ned's mother's dress, and he asked if I would wear it, and so I thought I would.
Hey, Ned! Bad luck for the groom to see the bride.
Well, I'm not superstitious. I just wanted to check to see if everything was okay.
Everything's fine, Mr. Ned.
Paula. Nobody can pull off white like you. You look great in Mommy's dress.
Mommy's dress. Why are the Crandalls here?
I guess they're friends with Ned.
Just getting you now.
Because now I'm about to actually do it.
Anything wrong?
No, everything's fine.
I'm sorry, Ned, but I can't marry you.
Except for that.
You can't what?
Marry you.
Don't listen to her. She's out of her mind from the excitement.
No.
She doesn't mean it. She's just a little nervous. It's only her second wedding.
I do mean it. I don't love you.
Don't.
What's love got to do with getting married? You and Daddy didn't love each other.
That's right.
We did when we got married.
Come on, let's get started. Dearly beloved, we're gathered here.
I'm not getting married.
Don't do this to me. This is our only way out.
Start the wedding! You think this woman to be your lawful wedded?
I have spent my whole life doing what other people want me to do. It's time I started to think about myself. I am not marrying you, Ned, and that's final. Oh, my goodness.
Sorry. For 30 years, every woman I've ever been with, I pretended was you.
I'm sorry.
You lied to me. You said that you forgave me, but you didn't.
Ned.
You never talk to me. You never let me explain why I had sex with your mother.
You slept with my grandma?
I was an innocent victim of circumstances.
So that's why grandma's picture's not around the house.
The woman seduced me. What could I do?
What a pig!
Who's a pig? I'm a pig. You're a pig.
Get off our land.
off our land? People haven't talked like that since the Civil War.
Beat it, Monk!
Look, I ruined you once, Schloss. I'll do it again.
Ah, that's why Quandle's here.
Get off our land.
Yeah.
I'll get even with you for this. I'll get even with all of you.
You sleep with one fiancé's mother, and it haunts you for the rest of your days. Life stinks. I rest my case.
We don't need Ned Monk or his money.
I can't believe you're supporting me in this.
I just want you to be happy.
You do love me.
Of course. You're my mom.
I think he loves me.
I'm not going.
This is the happiest wedding I've ever been to.
Why do we have to leave the fish farm, Grandma?
Because we don't have the money to pay for it.
Where will we live?
Oh, we'll go back to the city and live in my apartment.
All of us?
You bet all of us. We may not have any money, but...
But what?
But... I don't know.
The fish are born! Yeah! The fish are born! The fish are born! The fish are born!
And so, Schloss Fish Farm sprung up across the country. Everyone in the world begins eating the high-protein, inexpensive, pollution-free Schloss fish. Overnight, the Schloss family becomes fish royalty. And that's why, today, fine fish restaurants and fine fish markets all across our land carry the fine Schloss fish logo. And for their main course at their traditional Thanksgiving dinner, the Schlosses don't eat turkey. They don't eat roast beef. They eat fish. Schloss fish.
Revolution. Lady Stetson, a declaration of independence. Wear it.
This is Tropicana Pure Premium. No other major brand of juice comes closer to this than Pure Premium. Now this is Tropicana Pure Premium Homestyle for those with fond memories of Mom's juice. Homestyle is filled with juicy bits of real orange, like Mom's. So if you like the taste of juicy bits, no other major brand comes closer to this than Pure Premium Homestyle. Either way, you just can't pick a better juice.
Does your sinus medicine put you to sleep? You need Sudafed Sinus. With a non-aspirin pain reliever for sinus headaches, plus a decongestant for pressure that starts to work in as quick as 22 minutes. Without drowsiness. Sudafed Sinus. Fast relief, not fast asleep.
When you rinse first with Plax, normal everyday brushing takes on a whole new meaning. Plax, clinically shown to remove more plaque than brushing alone.
When it comes to high performance, no regular battery performs better or longer than a Duracell. You can't top the copper top.
Up next, Chicago's black community trying to launch a consensus candidate for mayor tonight.
Another confrontation over charges of racial harassment at the U of I Chicago.
Rescue workers searching for victims of a construction site explosion in Washington, D.C.
Plus, how to make sure you get accurate results from mammograms. All of those stories next on Channel 5.
Beginning Tuesday, today's with our troops, Katie Couric in Saudi Arabia. Deborah Bryant and Willard are aboard the Teddy Roosevelt, and Joe holds down the fort for Georgia's Fighting 24th.
Tuesday, a shocking murder.
Kid's dead.
Rocks the city.
Keep your mouth shut or you're dead.
Pitting cop against cop.
I want my day in court.
And threatens to tear apart the force.
Your partner?
Get off him. You're paying.
You get caught, you get prosecuted.
A fight for law and order on NBC Tuesday.
Gets dragged into the glitzy, greedy world of high-fashion photography when Conrad's heartstrings are tugged by a beautiful but dangerous model. This is Nancy Stafford. Say cheese for Matlock. Tuesday.
Then, on In the Heat of the Night, Chief Gillespie tries not to let a personal interest influence a murder investigation. Followed by Law and Order. Tuesday on NBC.